We are taking chapter number 3, Money and Credit. We saw the two different credit situation. First for Salim, second for Swapna. Now Salim, in the first situation, a person borrows money for the production activities. And the promise is that he is going to repay the loan at the end of the year or after the production is done. At the end of the year or after the production is done, he made a very good profit, and also he is able to pay the amount of loan. That is, the person will become better. As you see, Salim become better. He gets a good profit. The second situation is Sapna's situation. The person borrows money for production activities, and the promise is to repay the loan after the production is done. But at the end, he or she, like Swapna here, she is unable to pay the loan or repay the loan because the crop is not working, or you can say there is a loss in production. So this is a situation, we call it as a debt trap. And therefore the person becomes worse. You know, taking a loan that is making the life better will not happen like that, but the life will become more worse. So these are the two situations. That is, taking a loan can make the individual's life good, or it can make it worse. So what are the terms of credit? The interest rate, collateral, and there are certain documents. These are to be fulfilled. These are the requirements for terms of credit. Properly, interest rate is specified when anyone, like the lender or the bank, provides the money to the borrowers. The person who is taking money is the borrower. Now, borrower will have to repay the amount taken from the lender with some amount of interest. In certain cases, lenders may demand collateral against these loans. So let me tell you what is there. If you go to a bank will give you a paper, okay? It will have all the terms and conditions that this is your interest rate, say 10%. Just taking an example. Now, if you have taken 100 rupees, then 10% is what? It is 10 rupees. So you have to repay 110 rupees every year. Means if you have to pay, not every year, but it has to be all the way 110 rupees, 10 has to be added. Now, if the condition is that you will pay every month 10 rupees, then this becomes into 10 by 100, that is 1 rupees every month you have to pay as, or every year, whichever way it is, you have to repay. So now these are the terms and condition that this is the interest rate you have to pay. It can be monthly, it can be yearly also. Then how you have to pay, in what kind of installment, that is 100 rupees you have to pay, 10 rupees every month, every year, like this. So there is a term and condition. Then the third thing is the collateral. What is the collateral? What happens that you take a money from someone, say a money lender or a bank. Now you take 100 rupees and you don't return. You just run away, or you are not in a position to give the money to this person or a bank. Now what this money lender will do, because he has nothing. So he has to have some type of collateral, that is the papers of the land, some kind of ornaments, or some kind of thing which, if you don't pay, this bank or this money lender can sell it to get this money or to recover this money. So this collateral is an asset. Is an asset, like you have a land, you have something, some money, or you know, not in the liquid form, or you have something which can be liquidated, or which can be liquidated in the form of money. It can be taken by a money lender in the form of money if you don't repay the loan. So collateral is an asset of borrowers which is given to the lenders as security. It is a security for that specified period. If you don't pay, this is a security. So a lender can use the assets which you have kept as a collateral, which are held by the lender or the bank, as security until the amount of loan you repay. If you repay, then you will get all the security back. That is, the lender has now the right to sell the assets or the collateral. These are the same thing. When the borrower doesn't pay or fails to repay the amount of loan in a specified period. So if you run away, you don't repay the loan, then the lender has the collateral, or you can say the asset, whatever he has taken from you. Now he can just use this to get the money back. Here is an example of house loan. You'll understand these. We have already talked about the terms of credit. That is, if you take the money from money lender or bank, there is a proper way, there is a proper tarika. That is, this is the interest rate, this is the money you have to repay every month, and these are the collateral, or these are the assets paper you have to give us. So these are the terms of credit. Now we'll take an example of a house loan. Now Megha has taken a loan of 5 lakh rupees from the bank to purchase a house. The annual interest, that is, this is 5 lakh. The annual interest, that is per year, she has to pay 12%, that is 5 lakh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 12%, this will be 60,000. Per year, she has to pay 60,000 per, this is the interest only. And this has to repaid, to be repaid in 10 years. So 10 years, so there are 12 months. So 120 installments will be there of this 60,000 along with the actual amount. So Megha has to submit the bank and the documents, because she has to show that she has some employment. She has to put the salary in front of them, because the bank has to agree that, okay, you have some source of income. If you don't have source of income, how can we give loan for your house? So these are the collateral papers, or these are the bank retain this as collateral, and for the new house they you are going to take. And once you, this house, it is called, they will only disburse the money when you have shown all the paper, terms of credit you have all done, and after that you have repaid the loan, then the paper of this house will be returned to you. Otherwise, by the time you are paying for 10 years, the papers will remain with the bank only. So there are different types of credit arrangements. That is, the way you take the loan, there are different types of arrangements. We'll see a few of them. First is Shyamal. Now Shyamal is what? Every season he needs loans for cultivation. He has just 1.5 acres of land. And he used to borrow money from the village money lender, and the interest is 5%. That is 5% per month. Every month 5%. That is 60% in an year. That's a huge amount. Now this Shyamal is borrowing from now agriculture trader in the village. The interest rate is 3% per month. When the crop beginning season comes, the trader supplies the farm inputs as credits, like all the inputs he wants for the cultivation, which is to be repaid when the crops are ready to harvest. And one more thing is there, that the Shyamal has to pay the interest. Also, he has to, the promises with the trader is the crop has to be sold only to the trader. Now the trader does what? He takes the crop in a very less amount. Now he sells it otherwise to other people with a very good margin. So this is how Shyamal is under the credit arrangement. Then Arun is also there, and he is supervising the work of one farm labor, right? And he has 7 acres of land. He is one of the few persons in Sonpur, that is the village, and he is receiving bank loan for cultivation. The interest rate is 8.5% per annum, per year, and this can be paid in next 3 years. So Arun is planning to repay after he will harvest, and the one part of the harvest crop he will sell and he will repay the loan. And then he wants to store also the potatoes he is growing in the cold storage, and for that also bank is providing the loan, right? Cold storage receipt, bank is also giving money for that. So this is how Arun is taking the debt, loan or credit. Rama is working in the, say, neighboring field. She is an agricultural laborer. And for several months, Rama has no work. For daily expenses, that is to, feed the kids daily, she need expenses. So she needs some loan. And if something happens, like some illness or some functions, she has to take the loan. Rama takes the loan from the employer. And the employer is not very good with her. But still, Rama has no other option. She takes the money from the person who is the landowner, and she has to repay 5,000. So she is working and she is just repaying the loan, and she is taking the loan from the person who is owning the land. So these are certain arrangements you see, which are different kind of people take different type of credit or arrangements are there. Now, there are cooperatives. What are these cooperatives? These are called Sahakari Samiti. Now, these are people who are working in this field, say agriculture or say fisheries. Now, they get together. The person who is producing, the person who is selling, the person who is managing, all those people, they get together. And they get together and make a committee. They make a cooperative. Now, this cooperative can lend the loan to the people who are the member of that cooperative. So, whenever it is required for any purpose, not only for this cultivation or fishery, any other topic or any other field, if somebody wants to take the loan from the cooperative, he can take a loan on the prescribed interest rate. And once you have repaid the loan for the cooperative, you are again eligible to take the another loan. So, this is the cooperative and they are very successful. Most of the cooperatives we see are under the control or they are following the government rules. Now, there are two type of sector, formal sector and informal sector. So, there are two types of credit giving sector, formal sector and informal sector. If I can show you a graph. So, here we have the left one is the informal sector. You can take money from the money lender or landlord or say some trader or the relative or some other. So, this is the money you are taking from someone without any paperwork, or some paperwork, and they are charging you high cost interest, and these are the informal sector. When it comes to commercial banks and cooperative society, if you are taking loan or credit from the commercial banks and cooperative society, so this kind of situation is, or this type of institutions are called as formal sector. So we have two types of sector or two type of sources from the credit, from where the credit can be taken. One is formal sector, one is informal sector. So what is this formal sector? In this, as I just told you, commercial bank and cooperative society, government controlled, you can say the government approved registered cooperative society. In the formal sector, loans from banks and cooperatives are included. But in informal sector, all the money lenders, your friend, relative or landlords who charges you for us, you say quick loan, these are the people. When we talk about informal sector, in the informal sector, we have money lenders, traders, it can be employers, your relatives, your friends, or even your neighbors. As we know, the major portion of the deposited money is provided to those people who are needy of money for economic activities. Reserve Bank of India is the authority which supervises the banks and the cooperatives. How the function of the bank is going on. That is, RBI is supervising the functioning of our loan activities in formal sectors like bank, like cooperatives. So in India, the rate of interest in informal sector is quite greater. If you go to money lender, he will charge you more. So the rate of interest of informal sector is quite higher than the rate of interest in the formal sector. That is, if you saw the 60% for an year, the money lender is charging, but the bank is charging only 8.5%. So the rate of interest, and that 8.5% is for whole year. So rate of interest for formal sector is supervised by the legal authorities. In the informal sector, but on the other hand, the rate of interest is supervised by anyone and the rate of interest is not fixed. You can be charged anything. So money lender, trader, employers who are providing the money. Now the rate of interest is varying. Everyone can give you the loan in any other amount. It depends on your requirement. So there is no organization, there is no institution who is supervising loan in informal sector, because that is why it is called informal. This is not formal. This is not government regularized or government known. So lenders can use any method to get back their money from the borrowers in the informal sector. They can even, do something to you. That is, they can take your stuff from your house. So this can also happen. Sometimes the incomes of the borrowers become less compared than the amount which has to be paid due to the high rate of interest. That is the amount you have taken from the informal sector. Sometimes the interest being charged is quite higher than what you are repaying. So these are the situations as I told you, but these are the situation how this is informal sector, this is the formal sector. Formal sector is government authorized or government RBI is taking care of it, that the thing should not go offhand. That is, the bank should not give loans only to the bigger person or the rich person. A bank should give loan to everyone who is requiring the loan. Now here, if you see, there is a chart, or you can say there is a pie chart. Here, the poor household, 85% loan they take from the informal sector. But if you talk about rich household, 90% loan they take from the formal sector, that is the bank and cooperatives. And in between, if you see, there is a, you know, a variety that household with very few assets, they take 53% from the informal sector, 47% from the formal sector. Well-off household, they take 72% from the formal sector, but 28% from the informal sector. So what we saw here is that the source of credit in rural areas, that is the Gaon, Gramin area, these are mostly dependent on the professional and agriculture money lenders, that is the sahukars, in case of informal sources of loan. And if we want development of a country, then the loan from the bank, from the Sahakari Samiti should be available in cheap and affordable rate. Therefore, the government should facilitate the formal sources of credit basically in rural areas, because rural areas, they don't have the collateral and they need money always. So they just go to everyone like money lenders and take money in any interest rate, and that, and they are just, you know, round and round in a debt trap. Now there are certain self-help groups also for the poor. Now what are these self-help groups? The facilities of bank, mostly because it has increased now, but most places they don't have these availability of banks. So poor, they are always dependent on the sahukars, the money lenders, that is the informal sector. So the poor has to pay very high interest of loan to the money lender. And why? Because it is very difficult for them, because they are somewhat illiterate or they are not having that exposure. So they don't borrow the loan from the bank. And they don't have collateral also, they don't have documents also. The garib person, the poor person will not have anything. And when you don't have anything, you will not get the loan from the bank. And the document and collateral required from the bank, the poor or the rural people may not have. So informal lenders, like the money lenders, they may give the loan without collateral, but because they may know the person personally, but they will charge a very high rate of interest. So an organization constituted to collect the saving of poor, which is known as a self-help group. Now this self-help group has an aim. The aim of this self-help group is to lend loan at very less rate of interest compared to what money lenders are giving. And this self-help group, for say it may be 15 to 20 members, and savings, this can vary from member to member, that is say 25 or 100, depending on the ability to save, that is ability of the person to save. Now this organization or this type of organization, they provide self-employment opportunities also to the member of this group. For instance, small loans can be given or provided to the members for releasing mortgage loan, for meeting the working capital needs, for housing materials, for acquiring assets also. And this is also a group of repaying the loan. So in case of any non-repayment by one of the members, this is followed by the other members also, this follow them, that is they see that it has to be repaid properly. So this is a self-help group that people make. So this is an example of women self-help group meeting in Gujarat, and these people have combined together, they take money, and just whoever requires the money that can be given, and this is all in Vishwas, means all things goes on a trust between one another. And there is a Gramin bank in Bangladesh. We must understand that the Bangladesh is way up in the ranking of textile as compared to India. Bangladesh is a very small country, very very small country, and it is way higher than us, or way in export of textile. It is much higher in ranking than us, that is India. Now the thing is that there is a Gramin Bank of Bangladesh, and this has shown that if the money is given to the poorest section, you need to trust the poor section, you need to give money to them, and when you give money to them, they will do chamatkarik activities, that is they will do something which is really helpful to the economy, to the country. So what we saw here is that the money and the credit money, how the money changed its way from barter system to the currency system, now the banking system. And we talked about the depositors and the borrowers. We deposit the money and 15% bank keep always, and the borrowers take the money as loan, and the difference between them is the money which the bank earns. Now there are different type of credits, Credit can be taken from the formal sector, informal sector. Formal sector, we have the money lenders, your friends, etc. And the informal sector, it's bank and Sahakari Samiti, that is the cooperatives, right? Now, the loan giving facility of to the poor is quite complex. So now it is our duty, it's government duty to boost up the banks and cooperative society so that the credit can be given to everyone who is in need of money, and you have to have trust. Only then the development of the country can take place. So this is all about this chapter. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.